Texas band's inception in 1978. They've released over a dozen albums. They're headed for Australia, Japan, and even Europe to tour, yet you've probably never heard of them.
Like, Descendents are the best story ever.
They're like the punk rock Beach Boys.
This like shameless love song aesthetic, you know? None of the other bands have the balls to do that. Everyone was screaming about Reagan or whatever.
Bigger dorks, better songs.
I didn't see cats like that in other bands. Tony and Frank and Billy come to Stevenson.
Of course, Milo.
Milo.
Milo was kind of iconic, you know, he had his own logo.
I've just got this whole dichotomy of desires. You know, I want to rock out and I want to be like a punk rock guy. But I also have this really strong ambition to be a scientist.
Botanist, chemist, something like that.
I want to be stereotyped.
It's right here in my heart to see these guys again. This is Milo of the Descendents, and I'm sorry.
I'm Bill.
Bill.
Bill is the brainchild behind the Descendents.
It is trippy that they were a drummer-run band.
The Descendents were definitely creating the sound and the aesthetic that would go on to make bands like Green Day or Blink-182 famous.
Their sound got co-opted.
It wasn't about how much we got paid or how many records we sold. This was a love thing for us.
Because our whole goal was like, yeah, no, it's cool. There's this thing called punk rock. Now let's take it somewhere.
Folks, give a nice warm welcome to all.
They're formerly called the Descendents, they're now simply called All.
It's hard to be in a really big band and then start another band.
We all know that All is the band guilty of not being the Descendents.
Guilty of not being the Descendents. Same band, different singer.
You have to be a fan at the whole thing.
What will it be like when I get